Hello friends, in previous video we have studied the construction and working of the Francis turbine. In this video we are going to solve the problem related to Francis turbine. So let us study how to solve the problem on Francis turbine. So the problem one on the Francis turbine can be stated as following data relate to Francis turbine. First, net head is equal to 70 meter. Then speed is equal to 700 rpm. Overall efficiency 85%. Shaft power is 350 kilowatt. Hydraulic efficiency is 92%. Flow rate, that is Vn multiplied by under root 2gh, is equal to 0.22. Then breadth ratio, that is B/D or B divided by D, is equal to 0.1. Then the outer diameter of runner is equal to twice of the inner diameter of the runner. Then velocity of flow, that is Vf, is constant. Outlet discharge is radial. The thickness of vanes occupies 6% of circumferential area of the runner. Determine first the guide vane angle. Second, runner wear angle at inlet and outlet. Third, the diameter of runner at inlet and outlet. Fourth, width of the wheel at inlet. Now let us solve this problem. Now various data is already specified in the problem, so we'll directly start with the solution. So the velocity triangles for the Francis turbine can be drawn as so these are the triangles related to the Francis turbine. So this is the first triangle and this is the second triangle. Now the flow rate can be given by the equation. Flow rate is equal to Vf1 divided by root 2gh. But in the problem it is mentioned that the value of flow rate is equal to 0.22. Hence we can write Vf1 is equal to 0.22 multiplied by under root of 2gh. Now we know that value of g is nothing but acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.81, whereas h is nothing but the head, which is already mentioned in the problem. So let us substitute these values in this equation. Hence we get, therefore Vf1 is equal to 0.22 multiplied by under root of 2 multiplied by 9.81 multiplied by 70. Further solving this equation, we get the value of Vf1 as 8.153 meter per second. Now the value of Vf1 is similar to value of Vf2, hence we can write Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is equal to 8.153 meter per second. Now we know that formula for AB can be written as AB is equal to 0.94 multiplied by pi D1 into B1. Now the discharge of the outlet is given by in the numerical, it is mentioned that discharge at the outlet is radial. Hence, we can write therefore, for the radial discharge, Vw2 is equal to 0, Vf2 is equal to Vf1 is equal to 8.153. Now, we know that formula for the efficiency can be written as efficiency is equal to shaft power divided by outlet power. This equation can be further modified as efficiency is equal to 350 kilowatt divided by 1000 multiplied by Q multiplied by 9.81 multiplied by 17 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. Now, if we want to find the value of Q, that is discharge, then we can remodify this equation as Q is equal to 350 kilowatt divided by 1000 multiplied by efficiency multiplied by 9.81 multiplied by 70 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. Substituting the value of efficiency in this equation, we get Q is equal to 350 divided by 9.81 multiplied by 70 multiplied by 0.85. Further solving this equation, we get the value of discharge as therefore, discharge, that is Q, is equal to 0.5996 meter cube per second, which is nearly equal to 0.6 meter cube per second. Now, we know that there is another formula for discharge Q, which is written as Q is equal to 0.94 multiplied by pi multiplied by D1 multiplied by B1 multiplied by VF1. We can simplify this formula as D1 is equal to Q divided by 0.94 multiplied by pi multiplied by B1 multiplied by VF1. We can further modify this equation as D1 is equal to Q divided by 0.9 into pi multiplied by 0.1 D1 multiplied by VF1. We know that B1 is equal to 0.1 D1. Hence, we have substituted instead of B1, 0.1 D1. Now, let us take this 0.1 D1 on that side of equation. Hence, we get 0.1 D1 square is equal to Q divided by 0.9 pi multiplied by VF1. Now, substituting the values in this equation, we get 0.1 D1 square is equal to 0.6 divided by 0.9 pi multiplied by 8.153. Further solving this equation, we get therefore 0.1 D1 square is equal to 0.0260. Now, let us take the 0.1 on that side of equation. Hence, we can directly find the value of D1 as D1 is equal to square root of 0.0260 divided by 0.1. Further solving this equation, we get the value of D1 as D1 is equal to 0.5 meter. Now, B1 is equal to 0.1 multiplied by D1. Substituting the value of D1 in this equation, we get the value of B1 as therefore, B1 is equal to 0.05 meter. Similarly, the value of D2 can be found as D2 is equal to D1 divided by 2. Substituting the value of D1 in this equation, we get D2 is equal to 0.25 meter. Similarly, we can find the value of VB1 as VB1 is equal to pi D1n divided by 60. We have calculated the value of D1. Hence, substituting the value of D1 in this equation, we get VB1 is equal to pi multiplied by 0.5 multiplied by 700 divided by 60. Further solving this equation, we get the value of VB1 as VB1 is equal to 18.33 meter per second. Now, the formula for the efficiency can be written as efficiency is equal to VW1 multiplied by VB1 divided by G multiplied by H. Rearranging this equation to find the value of VW1, we get VW1 is equal to efficiency multiplied by G multiplied by H whole divided by VB1. Substituting the values in this equation, we get VW1 is equal to 0.92, that is hydraulic efficiency, multiplied by 9.81 multiplied by 70 whole divided by 18.33. After solving this equation, we get the value of VW1 as, therefore VW1 is equal to 34.47 meter per second. Now the formula for finding the value of tan alpha can be written as, tan alpha is equal to VF1 divided by VW1. We want to find the value of alpha. So, taking tan inverse, we get, therefore, alpha is equal to tan inverse of VF1 divided by VW1. Substituting the values in this equation, we get alpha is equal to tan inverse of 8.153 divided by 34.47. Further solving this equation, we get the value of alpha as, alpha is equal to 13.30 degree. Similarly, the value of beta can be found as, let us write the equation for tan beta. Hence, we get tan beta is equal to VF1 divided by VW1 minus VB1. Again, we want to find the value of beta. So, taking tan inverse, we get, therefore, beta is equal to tan inverse of VF1 divided by VW1 minus VB1. Substituting the values of VF1, VW1 and VB1 in this equation, we get, therefore, beta is equal to tan inverse of 8.153 divided by 34.47 minus 18.33. Further solving this equation, we get the value of beta as, so the value of beta, that is beta 1, is equal to 26.80. Similarly, the value of beta 2 can be found as, tan beta 2 is equal to VF divided by VB2. Hence, we can write VB1 divided by R1 is equal to VB2 divided by R2 is equal to omega. Hence, we can rearrange this equation as, VB2 is equal to D2 divided by D1 multiplied by VB1. Now we have calculated the value of D2, D1 as well as VB1. Substituting in this equation, we get VB2 is equal to 0.25 divided by 0.5 multiplied by 18.33. Further solving this equation, we get the value of VB2 as, therefore, VB2 is equal to 9.165, which is equal to 9.17 meter per second. Hence, this is equal to value of VB1. Therefore, VB2 is equal to VB1 is equal to 9.17 meter per second. In this way, we have solved this problem and find out various parameters. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.